In this video, I'm going to show you how to reduce video file size without losing quality using Handbrake. Hi, my name is David, and if this is your first time checking out my video tutorials, kindly consider subscribing if you like what you see. I've already walked you through a couple of Handbrake tutorials, mostly on adding subtitles permanently or even as soft subtitles. In this video, I'd like us to use Handbrake to reduce the file size of our video. Now, I have a video here and it's about 188 MB and it's a 51 second video. What this means is that if I had a longer video from the same camera, is that I'd have a very big video file here to deal with, although it may be like 10 minutes, but almost consuming like 3, 4, 5 GB. So what we need to do here is, for you that don't know Handbrake, it's an application that is available for Linux, Mac, and Windows, and I'm using Handbrake for Windows. So the latest is Handbrake 1.33, and you can check out all the other platforms that are supported. I'll have the link to Handbrake in the description below. So our video file is already available, and I have Handbrake installed on my computer. So you can just open it up, Handbrake. The most important thing when doing this is that you need to know the dimensions of the video. For example, this video is in 1920 by 1080, and this is a high definition video. This is one of the most important things you need to look at before you start compressing the video to a smaller file size. So Handbrake is open, and you have two options. You can either click on file and open as a single video, or you can just drop the file or the folder here. So I'll just drag and drop our video, just drag and drop, holding the left click and release. And once I release, I barely look at what preset do we have. So for starters, we have this fast preset, and it gives us this option. Now it's written fast 1080p 30. If you look at the size of the video, it's 1920 by 1080. So this is taking up what is called 1080p. So what I need to do here is that I'll need to click web optimized. That is the first option that I need to select, and then come and confirm from the video dimensions that the width down here is the same as the source. Because if this goes to something like 1280 by 720, then that means that your video is going to be cropped. That is, some sections will be cut off. So I don't do anything else there. Just come to the filters, nothing there. Just come to the video. Now from the video, we can just come and say for the frame rate, we select the frame rate to be same as source, because I know the video frame rate is about 29 frames per second. And we can see that from here, 29 frames per second. And once I'm done with that section, I'll just come back and then say the frame rate should be constant. Now, the only other option that I touch is this section, and this is what determines what type of quality you will get from the video. If you move this slider towards this direction, you get a lower quality video and a very small size. But if you move this slider towards the right, you get a higher video quality, but also a higher video size. So that's all we need to do. But for starters, you can even test with this, the 22 constant quality, 22, the RF. And you'll notice that you'll get a smaller video size, but the quality is almost identical to the original file. So sometimes you just don't need to change this, but if you wanted to change, you can move it to about, let's say 23, but I leave it at around 22 where it was. It does the job. So you just check if the audio track is available. Yes, it is. And if you had subtitles to put into that particular video, that is to hard code or even embed, you can do that from this particular section. But we don't have anything else to add, so we'll move down to our saver section and click on browse, where you want to go and save our new video file. Let's say H. Okay, how to reduce video file size without losing quality. Now, if you notice, it has an extension of .m4v, but we can always change that. Let's say reduced or compressed. Let's say compressed. And then .mp4. Once you do that, just click on save. And if you're satisfied with your selection, just click on start encode. It's going to start encoding your video file into a smaller file size that can save you space on your computer and even make it easier for you to share the files with other people without taking too much internet bandwidth. Depending on the length of the video and the resources of your systems, that is, if you have a better system that utilizes graphics card and all that, this is going to be a quick and simple process. Unfortunately, that's not the case for me, so it's going to take a little bit of time to compress the video file. Let's give it some time, and then we'll come back and see what file size we have at the end of it all. We're almost done with the encoding process from Handbrake, and it takes some time. It really depends on the resources of your computer, and as I've mentioned, I have a wacky computer, so it's not going to really do me good unless I'm leaving a whole project overnight. So once it's complete, you'll see that the video file size will have reduced. And as I mentioned, Handbrake can help you reduce video file sizes in Mac, Linux, Windows. So all operating systems are covered and you can do it in whichever application that you use. So it's almost done and it's going to hit done maybe in just like a couple of seconds. And it's taken a long time, give or take like 9 minutes. But there's something else. There's another process that was running. So once it's done, it's going to give us queue is finished. We can just minimize this. And this is the original file. It's 188 MB. And this is the compressed file. It's 35.6 MB. If I double click this original file to view it inside VLC Media Player.
Welcome to my YouTube channel. My name is David.
That's the original file. This is the compressed video file. Just double click on it again.
Welcome to my YouTube channel. My name is David and it's good to have you here.
You'll notice that there's no quality change of this video when I reduce the file size using Handbrake. So what I really wanted to show you is that you can compress a big video file from, let's say, 100 MB to maybe 30 MB or even smaller, depending on the settings that you have. But always make sure that you keep your dimensions identical to the original video to avoid cropping of sections or particular area of a video that may be important for a viewer. But this process can help you save your video files on your computer and therefore you reduce on the wastage of space. And then this process can also make it easy for you to share huge video files with people that you may want to use, especially if you have a low internet connection. Sometimes even if you're sending content to a client, you can do this so that if they have any changes to send to you, then you will not have wasted your bandwidth sending them the complete video file. Thank you so much for watching this video on how to reduce video file size without losing quality. I hope that you've learned something. I'll catch you on the next video. Thanks for watching.